Good evening, brothers and sisters. Welcome to another session of our weekly prayer meeting. Bago po tayo mag-umpisa, let's all bow down in prayer. Father God Almighty, Creator of heavens and the earth, Lord, we adore you, we exalt you on high, we give you the highest glory and adoration, Lord Father, because you deserve it. Lord, sa amin pong paglapit, pakalinisin mo po ang aming mga puso. Patawarin niyo po kami, Lord, sa aming mga pagkukulang at pagkakasala. At amin din pong samot panalangin, Lord, na patuloy mo kaming baguhin. Convict us with your Holy Spirit, O God, so that we can continue to walk according to your will. Lord, we ask for your wisdom today as we study your word. We just give you all the praises and glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Ang atin pong passage, mga kapatid, ay matatagpuan sa 1 Kings chapter 2, verses 2 to 3. So this was the time when David was about to die at nagbigay po siya ng mensahe sa kanyang anak na si Solomon. Together, let's read. Verse 2, I am about to go the way of all the earth, he said. So be strong, act like a man, and observe what the Lord your God requires. Walk in obedience to him and keep his decrees and commands, his laws and regulations as written in the law of Moses. Do this so that you may prosper in all you do and wherever you go. Ang pag-uusapan po natin is about understanding true success in obedience to God. I think many people would agree that life, mga kapatid, is a never-ending pursuit of happiness and success. Parati na po nating naririnig ito, pero the question remains, ano nga ba talaga ang ibig sabihin ng tunay na tagumpay for a Christian? According to statistics and research, success can mean different things to different people. For some, it can be right relationships, like marrying the right person or having kids. For others naman po, popularity, acquiring wealth, or being appreciated and recognized for your talents or abilities. So most of the time, people aim for power, position, pleasure, prosperity in terms of money, at marami pang iba. Most of these things are actually material things and are not really eternal, or they're not lasting. But regardless kung paano natin dine-define in our own way ang salitang success, we usually spend a lot of time, energy, attention, and effort trying to pursue these things, you know, through hard work, kaya tayo nagtatrabaho every day. And dumadating din mismo ang mga oras that we can become very discouraged, or we lose hope along the way if we feel that we are not achieving these things. However, we go back to the question, or to the reality, that we are Christians. So, what is success in a Christian's perspective? So, real success begins by obeying God's command to repent. Of course, believing in Jesus Christ and living according to His will. And then everything will be provided and will follow. Jesus was the most successful man that ever lived on earth. Pero nakita natin yung buhay niya, and we learned that he did not really strive to obtain more money or worldly belongings. As we consider success as something that we are all trying to aim for in life, it can also be a big challenge, or minsan pa nga nagiging balakid sa ating buhay, because we don't know, or we have a misunderstanding of what success really is. Success sometimes becomes an idol in our lives, and that replaces our devotion to God. Nakakalimot tayo when we get too busy with working and many more. And sometimes, even, you know, the pursuit for success and happiness, di nyo ba napapansin, it can actually turn friends into competitors. It can make us prone to corruption, ayan, cheating, or there's greed, arrogance, you know, we can boast about it. Or sometimes, ang nakakalungkot niyan, when we don't achieve those things, we get disappointed. Marami ding taong nagiging nade-depressed because of it. We all know that in the Bible, success is not about achieving these things. Rather, biblical success is always about being faithful to God. So, mabalik po tayo dun sa 1 Kings. We can see there na binigyan ni David ng instruction ng kanyang anak na si Solomon. But notice that David didn't tell his son to focus on acquiring wealth, building up their kingdom, beating their enemies, and no worldly acquisitions. But David told his son to focus on God and being faithful to his word. So, or ano nga ba ang makukuha natin from, you know, being faithful and obeying God? Maraming bagay actually, pero these are some. We can have true contentment in life. You know, the ability to handle life's problems na hindi tayo na-overcome nun or yung madali tayo maapektuhan kapag nagkakaroon tayo ng mga problema. And that means that we have that amazing peace that comes from God because we know that He sees through all the circumstances and we can understand, we have that confidence that God provides and He will never forsake us and He will always be there for us. And also the wisdom to know what to do, to classify right from wrong, you know, knowledge and constant direction for life. When we are passionate talaga sa pagsunod sa Kanya, nagkakaroon ng direksyon ng ating buhay kasi siya mismo ang nagtuturo nun sa atin. And we also learn to love other people, be compassionate, you know, acceptance of ourselves, loving ourselves as well as how God loved us. And yung joy, yung hindi actually happiness because happy being happy is temporary. Pero yung joy na kahit dumadaan ka sa mga pagsubok, alam mo na that joy that comes from the Lord, it's in you and that you can continue living kahit na dumadaan ka sa mga trials or challenges ng buhay. And of course, at the end of life, we also have that assurance of salvation and we know that after we die or after our, you know, journey here on earth, we have an eternity with the God who freely gives and who is continually giving all of those things to us. So mga kapatid, kung gusto talaga nating sundin at andun yung desire natin to really obey and submit to God, of course, we really have to read and study the Bible. There is another passage, mga kapatid, na related sa topic natin ngayon, na napakaganda, mga kapatid. We are very familiar of the passage that comes from Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 to 6, where it says, "To trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not lean on our own understanding." If we really read from the first verse, mas lalo pa nating ma-appreciate yung passage na yon. From verse 1, it says, "My son, do not forget my teaching, but let your heart keep my commandments. For the length of days and years of life and peace, they will add to you. Let not steadfast love and faithfulness forsake you. Bind them around your neck, write them on the tablet of your heart, so you will find favor and good success in the sight of God and man." Generally speaking, maraming tao or most people actually want to have a long life. And the reason for that is to keep relationships. That's why we grieve kapag yung mga taong malapit sa atin o mga mahal natin sa buhay face death is because we want to be with them longer. At dahil gusto natin na makasama sila ng mas matagal pa, we see a lot of technological advancements, medicinal innovations, may anti-aging na, pinag-aaralan na rin ang cloning. May mga health supplements, ano pa ba? At napakabilis na ginawa yung mga vaccines is because it was so tragic yung rate ng casualties ng COVID na to ay sobrang bilis. At syempre ayaw natin yon na mangyari or ayaw natin nun na madaming namamatay. At gusto nating iiwas yung mga mahal natin sa buhay from getting sick or worse na syempre na mamatay sila because of any kind of sickness or virus. So nakikita natin yung value ng life here on earth. But we go back to the foundation is from the Bible. It teaches us here on how we can live a long life. We not only get the long life na gusto natin, but a long and peaceful life that God promised for us if we keep His commandments. And kung going back to the verse 4, sabi dito, you will find favor and good success. Good news mga kapatid, we do not actually have to achieve God's favor anymore because He freely grants it to us. Because we have already accepted Him as our Lord and Savior. Mga kapatid, let's all be reminded that true success is walking with God and experience the joy of His favor and presence in our lives. So, we really need to obey Him in every situation. Confidently give your best efforts and trust to Him. You know, the blessings, the provisions will follow your faithful efforts. So, God bless mga kapatid. I give all the glory and honor to our God for everything that He has done for you and me, for every one of us.